I'm Tobi and this is Sea Life.
Welcome back to the channel. Many of you have been wanting us to try out our new waffle maker. So tonight, here's our waffle maker use for the first time. This is our first time using it. So you're gonna see exactly what happens.
Yeah, we're preheating it right now.
Okay, and we're just gonna show the recipe we're using today. You can use your favorite recipe. We're gonna incorporate some of our pecan, what should have been pecan butter, and it didn't separate the way we thought it would, but that may have been the temperature. Maybe we didn't have the temperature high enough on the nuts when we ground them or something. Or it's just starting to separate, actually, but I just don't have patience for that. So we're gonna use it.
Should already be separated anyway.
So we're gonna use this, and we're going to use some honey. We're going to use some vanilla. We're gonna use some baking powder and some condensed milk and some reduced fat milk. We use a lot of shelled milk because we don't like it to go bad in our house. And olive oil.
And then regular flour too?
A little bit of regular all-purpose flour.
Yeah. That's actually bread flour. Yeah, that's bread flour. Yeah.
Bread flour. Okay. So that's Daniel looked up this recipe, and so we're just gonna throw it together and get on with this. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna put all of this into my bowl.
So we're adding 3/4 cup of regular flour.
Okay, that's pretty good. Just mix your regular flour in with your nut. And you know, this pecan nut has a lot of oil in it already, so I'm not sure I'm going to add very much oil. But we'll see.
The recipe calls for 1/2 cup.
It just depends on what the consistency looks like. So we're just blending in the regular flour with the pecan flour. Or pecan nut oil is actually what it should have been, but it turned out more like flour. So
yeah, it did.
I think you can actually use vice versa. You can use your nut oil or your nut
butter
as easily as you can the flour if you don't get it to actually turn creamy. These are not from our chickens because our chickens have been very stingy lately, but and they're hiding everything from us, I think. I don't know. We just haven't found the nest yet. So we went ahead and got some eggs from the store, which are a little easier to use because you don't have to check them for everything that you would eggs from the farm.
So we added 1/2 cup of milk?
1/2 cup of milk. And it's starting to look liquidy.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see.
That is not the consistency.
Okay, what's next? 4 tablespoons of honey.
Half teaspoon of kosher salt.
That's what the name is on the back. Okay, let's see. That kosher salt is clumpy. Okay, 1/2 teaspoon of kosher salt. Okie doke.
A teaspoon of
baking powder?
No.
Vanilla.
and a teaspoon of baking soda. Is that soda or powder?
This is powder.
You know why? Because you didn't add any milk or oil, yeah.
Yeah, I could add in just a little oil.
I have four on the side there. I'm not even close.
Yeah, I don't want to use near as much as it has said though, because I know my nuts have oil. But was it for that recipe? Oh, okay. Okay, this mixture has seemed so thick. So we added in some more milk, and we're adding more water. And we're trying to make it a little bit thinner so that we can use it for a waffle batter.
Waffle batter is way
thinner than this, yes.
How much you dump the water in there?
Yeah, I'm thinking. Yeah, let's just go ahead and I don't even know how much I did put in. But this is starting to look a little bit better. Oh yeah. Now we're cooking.
So we're warming up our waffle maker very slowly. But we have this glass top, and then we also have this
this little burner.
Little burner.
As a backup. Yeah, so we're gonna try the little burner.
Yeah, a little easier to get a hold of the handles on that. But we'll see how this goes. All right, we're gonna try to spread some oil on this so we can get some.
Do you want this? It's starting to heat up.
One more of those, probably.
Maybe we'll just do it.
Yeah, that's good.
Let's see how this goes.
And then I started it and I just flipped it because that other side was hot and this side wasn't. So now it just needs to go, well, it says 2 to 3 minutes.
We'll set your time and we'll see how that works.
Okay.
Here we go.
Okay, it's been 2 minutes, so check this out. It stuck to
it. It is stick. So we must have used to put like.
Alright, well that one didn't work very good.
Or better.
So we're gonna clean it up and see what happens.
You guys, this recipe did not work well for waffles. So
yeah,
we're
it's
going
definitely
to,
the recipe.
We're gonna, what we're gonna do is we're gonna save the day by just switching over to a pan and making pancakes. We'll get back to you on the next use of this waffle iron.
But we tried a little bit of that batter out of this, and it actually tastes really good.
It tastes good.
So
we'll, good taste, and we just don't have the right consistency or something.
Yeah. To chunky.
Yeah.
Granulated, yeah.
So we originally made this flour up to be waffle batter. It did not work too good in the waffle machine, and we had a lot of, let me turn this up, a lot of trouble of trying to get it to make up. And as it is, this batter is not real good for pancakes either, but this is...
it's quite tasty though.
Yeah, and the guys have had a couple of these, and we're cooking in a cast iron stove here. So I've only got it at three. I heated it way up high at first, and then I've turned it down to 3.5, and I just keep adding a little oil to it. That one I turned a little bit early, it looks like, because it's very
doughy.
Doughy, yeah, this is...
But this thing, as you seen when she flipped it, it kind of came apart too.
Yeah, they kind of.
And that's the problem. And I'm positive that that's the deal with our waffle maker, is that the dough is so crumbly that it just doesn't want to make inside there. So we're going to try again with a real waffle recipe. Using real flour, and we'll see how that one goes first before we try any fancy stuff.
Using the regular flour.
But it's pretty good. I like the flavor.
I'm just gonna get me a paper plate over here.
And that one's yours, huh, baby?
It might be.
Adult.
It's hard to have a pancake guys to cook in our house. Okay.
Everybody and their brother wants to get
it. Still.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
I'm gonna flip that little piece back over. Anyway.
And then I'll let her go ahead and have one while I cook up some more. Alright, I put a little dough down in there. See, it doesn't run like normal.
No.
What's that?
Well,
it's too much salt. I don't know, I think the... didn't have enough gooiness. But, right. I just turned up the burner just a little bit. I think that hers was starting to get a little too cold. Yeah, just got it flipped. It looks pretty good on that side. You know, hey, nobody's perfect with getting it a little too done. But you know, my grandmother used to say that she loved burnt toast because of that nice charcoal-y taste, and she loved it.